Gemini. Oh, honey, I don't know who you are, but I just want to tell you, you are highly cognizant at this time, connecting with your emotions. You are reminded to connect with your higher self. And there is a direct link between your mind and the consciousness that you want to achieve by your attention to positive self-affirmation and reaffirmation. Reaffirmation is what I felt the need to say. You are very intuitive, my dear. Or sir. My dear. But you're not expressing or connecting with the truth that you know to be true inside of yourself. You also could be just connecting with any water sign. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Or not. Heavy Cancer with the Queen of Cups, so you let me know. Knight of Swords, you desire communication. You are wanting to move forward to express a truth that you have not expressed, or they to you. Quite frankly. Your intuition feels a communication is coming. A call, incoming call for Gemini. Incoming message for Gemini, that makes perfect sense. You being the messengers and all. Welcome back to the channel, guys. Sorry, I forgot to totally introduce myself. My name is Ebony, this is White Crow Tarot. If you are new to the channel, welcome. Guys, kind of raw material here, raw tarot reader too, as it is. There is mild cursing on this channel sometimes. If you're uncomfortable with that, feel free to visit any other tarot reader. I know I'm not everyone's cup of tea, but, you know, I am who I am. Real person who does real tarot, and I tell it like it is, guys. But if something does resonate with you, be sure to stick around, leave a like on the video, subscribe as you see fit. I look forward to seeing you in more videos and readings. And Gemini, you guys always keep it interesting, so, you know. I am celebrating, guys. Recently, I just crossed 2K, so we are growing here steadily at White Crow Tarot. Growing steadily. Continuously. Abundantly, I might add. But, you know, I'll say this. For the growth that I've had, my subscribers keep getting richer. Gemini, and I know you can appreciate this. It's like, not just any old subscribers, there's actually a richness to my subscriber base. Like, you guys know your shit, you know what I mean? Like, you comment, you have intellectual things to say, and I know you can appreciate that, Gemini. It's not just frou-frou. I'm not putting down anybody who, you know, everybody, you know, tarot is one of those things. You can attract all kinds of people to your channel, but I like that the base that I have built, the family we have built here at White Crow Tarot, are very intellectual minded people, you know, and you engage in stuff, and I like that. I just like that. I like your energy. I like your energy, especially today, Gemini. I've always gotten along pretty well with Geminis my whole life. I can talk forever with Geminis. We have a lot to talk about, usually. Most of the time, we do. Yeah. We talk forever. Geminis, I know you like to hear things about yourself, though, so let's go. You know it's true, so shut up. You know it's true. Okay. Boy. All right, Gemini, in your current position, Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Watch. You're spending a little bit at this time. Also, you have recently come out of a family commitment, connection, something here that could be divorced from a water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Okay. The heart space is very intuitive, though. So, but you lost money. This is separation. I'm sorry, guys. Anytime I see the Ten of Pentacles in reverse, that's separation or loss of money. So we've been guarded on that front. Yes? Okay. Strength at this time, yeah. Four of Cups. No, no, no. Be careful. We're careful. Are we interested in an offer at this time from the divine, or is it just going to disappoint us like the last three offers did? Okay. Like the last three situations did in Gemini year. Or are we on to the next thing? Is it that flighty kind of whimsical? Well, those three didn't work out, so what's next? You know, it is your strength at this point in time. I'm not interested. Who just had that? Scorpio just had that. Theirs was a little weird, though. Weird energy for that. Read anyway. This could also be missed opportunity. How your person is viewing you as a missed opportunity, Gemini. I did almost say Scorpio, so maybe you are dealing with a Scorpio or have dealt with a Scorpio. Okay. Alrighty, yeah, we've been overthinking something, haven't we? Or we've been resting on the idea. Four of Swords. We've been sleeping. We've been on break. We have four into four here. We have been sleeping. Dreaming about this person. Interesting. Also, communication is shit between the two of you. Just felt like telling me. Alright, I know you don't want to hear it. I mean, you're here to hear it, so. You felt like hearing it, I just felt like telling you. Okay, communication is shit. I'm just letting you know. Alright, there's a lot of sleeping going on here. Someone ain't talking. Someone needs to. Like, Knight of Swords needs to talk. Someone wants to, too. About what? I don't know. But you do. Anyway, challenge is work. Eight of Pentacles. We throw ourselves into work because clearly this was separation in the past. So what do? When we go through breakups, we go through shit, we throw ourselves into work. We focus on our own endeavors, our own responsibilities, our own tasks, because it's what we're good at. And also, Gemini, you're inquisitive, and I admire this about you, because you kind of just keep it moving, you know what I mean? You are curious by nature. Your curiosity is one of the things that's your number one trait. It keeps you alive. It keeps you going. You will always be curious about the next thing. So, you're learning. You're learning, doing it for yourself. You're also personally invested into what it is you do, or you will be, into your next commitment, which I hope to see in the storyline here. Right now, we got a lot of underlying energy here. Oh, I knew it! I knew it! How did I know this? I knew I was going to see it. I knew I was going to see him. Okay, Capricorn, the devil here. In reverse, thank God. Someone's got a Capricorn placement, or a Capricorn has a Gemini placement, and they're here checking up on another. I knew I was going to see you today, Capricorn, in Gemini's reading. How did I know that? But also, I've noticed the devil's been popping up all over the place. You've been in a lot of reading. You've been in every reading so far, Capricorn. Whoever you are. Sorry, Gemini. Anyway, devil in reverse. I don't really feel anything bad for that card. Except the lovers are chained here to a situation. Ah! So in your potential outcome, there could be potential obsession, for sure. With someone, who knows? And you want to be chained. Some of you like that? I just heard chained? Okay. We're getting into some other intimacy things. Sorry, guys, I have to move that into an intimate tarot reading if we're going to go down that road. But you know what I mean. Oh, yeah, you do. I heard that. Chained. Okay. Do your thing, boo. Eight of Pentacles again on the bottom of the deck. You could know this person from work. You work with them periodically is also what I just heard. Now you're at the crux, that crossroads of, do I make a decision? Is the time now to come towards them? You could physically be at a distance from them. Sure. Two of Wands. You heard you work with this, we work with them. Communication. Let's go. Communication. You work with them periodically. Okay, cool. Where we make our money, Ten of Pentacles. Why is our finances hurting at this point in time? Is that why we're not taking action? Because we're focused? Because that's heavy work. like double, eight of coin twice here. Like, we are so focused on work, it's not even funny. So we lost a lot of money in a connection, and now we're making up for it. Okay. Show me this ten of coin. What's going on? We spent some money, didn't we? Yes, we did. Okay, we are all... Five of swords. No, we don't like that. No, Gemini. We do not like it. Heavy combativeness here. Some personal self-doubt. I ain't ready till I am ready, okay? Until that coin is right, until that bank is sitting where I like it, we ain't moving. We ain't doing shit. Okay? It's back in the Five of Swords. Or we straight up fight with this person a lot, and it's like, why? Yeah. The Empress in reverse. Taurus, Libra energy. Ew, that was our commitment, wasn't it? No more. I don't think so. No. Crosswatchers, reverse energies as it applies. You know if this is your story or not, but I'm just telling you, there was a lot of fighting here and a commitment, and someone was, quite frankly, very... They threw their status around. You know what I mean? I feel like someone made themselves out to be larger than what they were. Let's put it that way. You know? And now, we're disconnected. We hung up the phone on that situation. We said, done, bye, right? Bye! Okay, cool. Because now we're not interested. Four of Cups, not interested. Looking, but... Yeah. Why is the Four of Cups here? I would love to see a face card on this energy. The end with the Devil in reverse. No. I know you're overthinking it. Yeah, you are overthinking it. Hell of fire, you're overthinking it. That was too much, Gemini. Tone it back, Eight of Swords. We are overthinking it, okay? Overthinking what? Eight of Swords. Gotcha. Overthinking here. Trapped in a situation in our own head, or we can't stop thinking about this person, don't you? Maybe this is an Empress yet to be. Oh, okay. But, and we have personal self-doubt over whether or not we can here. But Queen of Cups, to the point. Double Queen of Cups here. Yeah, we're thinking about this person. We are really thinking about this person. Missed opportunity with a potential Empress here. I see. We felt personal. We did not take action with this person because we felt financially unstable. We didn't feel like we were good enough for this person. Whoever you are, Crosswatcher, Gemini, you yourself were saying, I did not feel good enough financially for this person. But why do you have to go so far to prove yourself? Why do we have to go so far to prove ourselves? If we're sensing such intuitive ability here, or it feels lovely. Whatever was trying to build over here felt so lovely. Why do we second guess? Why do we overthink the connection? Why did this connection not happen? We overthought it. Someone's sleeping over here. Okay? Straight up. Sleeping on this connection. Why? Why is the Eight of Swords here? Spent way too much time up in our heads thinking about it instead of being about it. You thought you were being judged? Someone did. I just heard that. You thought you were being judged for your finances. That's oddly specific for someone. That will not resonate with everybody, too. I know that. Okay. Eight of Swords. Not everything's meant to resonate with you, by the way. Put an end to that thought, Gemini. For real. Okay, all your energy here. So I know these are your thoughts. These are your thoughts. Remember, we're not there yet, but I feel the need to tell you we're connected to a higher consciousness. We have to get rid of these self-limiting beliefs because they don't serve you anymore. If someone wants to be abundant with you, they want you for you, not for what you have. And anyone who does, well, we know who those people are. They're gold diggers, and frankly, who got time for that? Now, unless you like it, that's one thing. That's one thing, but I think you know how to spot it. What are we overthinking? There was a truth you didn't have with this person. Ace of Swords in reverse. You did not have a truth with this person. There was some element of truth that was missed here. Some missed communication, missed opportunity. Like I told you, there was not a lie. It's not a lie. I don't sense it's a lie. It feels like miscommunication. Or no communication. We didn't even discuss it. It didn't even have the discussion. The hell? But we're thinking about it. And we're thinking about it. We didn't even have the discussion. I hope this changes. I want to see where this is going. I hope this changes. You're making me want to give it a good think now. Like, holy hell. Okay, yeah. We divested before we even had the conversation. Gemini. The hell. Someone here realizes it's like there was a waiting to exhale moment, but also like failure to exhale moment. Like, we just kept this thought inside of us this whole time. We never released it. We never released a breath of how we were feeling towards this person, how they made us feel, vice versa, of course. But like, nothing was expressed here. Emotions were not expressed here between the two of you about how you truly felt. And I don't know how I'm getting all this off of just so many cards. That was the ending. That's also what created the ending, but know that it's the end. You can put it down now because you've been overthinking it. You've been resting. Too much time has elapsed between the two of you. Why? Let's also say that in a couple of weeks you could have communication, lines of communication could be starting up between the two of you again. Three of Wands in reverse. As soon as you put the past behind you, as soon as you make a decision to move forward. Three of Wands reverses, the weakness is just the Three of Wands. Yeah, so as soon as you put the past behind you, your intuition knows that, by the way. Also, in reverse, the High Priestess, something will be revealed to you. She will spill the beans, something. You're hearing it. Maybe you're hearing it now. Maybe I'm spilling the beans for someone. I hope I am. I hope I'm helping you guys connect with someone. I feel like you had a beautiful opportunity to connect with someone here, and it's like it got missed. Sorry, that's why I'm all up in your business, like real fucking curious right now. Okay. Three of Wands. I don't normally get these kinds of readings with you, Gemini, so this is nice. Just letting you know. Okay, Three of Wands. Where are you going? Right then. King of Pentacles. We're going to our stability. We were worried about our finances, but we're perfectly stable here. Man or woman, I don't care. Let me know if you're dealing with a Taurus. We are perfectly stable and happy, and we've been on a long journey by ourselves. Possibly even closing off connections, not really interested, you know, little dalliances here and there, light dating, light flirtation, but nothing really blowing your skirt up, nothing really calling you back. I was about to say home. Why was I about to say back home? That makes no sense. I don't have anything for that, so take it as it resonates. Eight of Coin. We're working steadily. Do we work? Where do we know this person? From work? Oh, we're working. Yeah. Now we got a king and a queen. Holy hell. I knew Capricorn had to come out eventually. This will lead to higher level commitment, is what I just heard. You guys' backs, oh, you're facing each other. Holy hell. Oh my. So, and this could also be future category, in the future, there will be a marriage here, but there was a marriage here, and you want to work on it, been sleeping on it. Communication will happen to bring about this divine union, King and Queen of Pentacles, matching suites here. Let me know if you're dealing with a Capricorn. Or any earth sign, respectful. Okay, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Either way, Virgo energy here with the Eight of Coin. Let me know. It's all over your reading, though. Other signs here is Taurus, Libra, Cancer, and Capricorn. I'm surprised Scorpio hasn't shown up, and I'm only saying that because they always do when you're reading, so we'll see. What's backing that Queen of Coin? Where we meet this person, we see them as potential, we see them as stable. Oh yeah, vice versa again, of course. But we see them as stable. We want to move towards them, Six of Swords. Yes, we do. Someone, they want to come towards you, too. Yes, they do. They see you as stable. Very good. Very good. That is a private thought. I wasn't supposed to know that. Oopsie. Oopsie. I'm going to deal with the Pisces here. Alright, Devil. What's your hidden thought? What's your subject matter worth? What do you think about this situation? I want to know your thoughts, Capricorn, Devil. What you want to know? What you got to say about the situation? Like, I don't know why people blame me. I mean, that people make perfectly bad decisions on their own. Why do I get blamed for other people's mistakes? Like, they chose to go down the road that they went. Why do I get blamed? I'm in reverse here. I'm not even standing as myself, so I ain't got nothing to do with this situation, except for maybe passion. Passion. Anyway, why are you here? I'm still curious. We're having a conversation. I just thought you'd want to, you know, give your 2 cents on the matter. But that's okay with you. You know, I'd love to have your 2 cents on the matter. But, you know, if you're reserved, that's okay too. I get it. I understand. You do get blamed for a lot of shit. Anyway, Devil, why are you doing here? Because someone's moving towards you, just thought you'd like to know. Okay, yep, they sure are. Yep. Oh, baby. Hello. 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 The hidden thought was... Seven of Swords, reverse. Two. Lovers in reverse, Gemini. You. Why are you in reverse? Clarifying the Devil, you, and the Ace of Cups under that. Okay, this was a past person, past lover. I see. That was a hidden thought. Or someone who is yet to be your lover. If you want to be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. The fuck? Are we rolling like that? No. We rolling like that? If you want to be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Ooh, spicy. Spicy, Gemini. Some of you do roll like that. Okay. No worries, guys. No judgment, by the way. Yeah. Anyway. Multiple lovers. So there was an element of toxicity here. Maybe it was not what the other person wanted. Couldn't get them to see your... We didn't have that conversation. Okay. Interesting. We don't have third party here, but I felt it. That's why we rested on that, because we weren't sure how open they'd be to our personal sexual... I knew I was feeling BDSM with you. Yeah. I knew. Oh, I do wish this were an intimate, guys. I'd love to break this down. I feel it. There's something going on here. You felt like you could not be yourself to show who you really were. Who are you, babe? Gemini. Because now you're here. But you're in reverse, and I don't like to see you in reverse. There's an element of secrets, see, here. Why are you here? So far removed from this situation that you had to go into hiding. Especially, you had to go into hiding. Like I said, the moon dealing with Pisces at night, under the cover of night, at night. More Pisces energy. Look at all this hanged man. No one could see something. Someone did not get your perspective in reverse. That hanged man in reverse. Someone, double Pisces here. Holy hell. You did not. They did not get the perspective they needed about how to approach you. It made someone incredibly unhappy that they could not have their wish fulfillment. But was the conversation even had is my thought here. I can't see something from your point of view. I don't want to see something from your point of view. Tip for tat. Hey, nice. I really loved, you know, I'm going to start doing extendeds, guys. I think it's almost time. Like, it's time we started doing extendeds for the reading. Yeah, someone's going into hermit mode. Told you Virgo was in the mix here. Someone's going to withdraw for now. Withdraw. For now. I would love to break the story down some more. There's a lot of potential here. And I've never said that. So expect at some point I will start doing extendeds. If this is your story and you want to see something more personally tailored to you on this, possibly consider booking a personal with me. Alright. Everything's down below in the description. Anything else I need to know about that hermit? You're gonna ghost them? You did ghost them. Someone got ghosted here for sure. Oh yeah. Or you will. Wheel of Fortune. There will be a new cycle, a new change, a change. This will move forward again slowly but surely. Possibly in a few weeks. It's very interesting energy for you, Gemini. Wow. I hope this reading reaches who it needs to reach. This is one of your more exciting readings. I'm not gonna lie to you. This was fun. Wheel of Fortune. Let me know if you're dealing with a Sagittarius or a Capricorn. There's change. A change in your energy. A change in this shift. A change to that ghost. Because you do think about them. You keep that lantern lit for them. They'd keep it lit for you. Oh, interesting. Oh, boy. Okay. You have child from Dorian Virtue. You care deeply about children and they readily respond to your love. All children, including your own inner child, require love, affection, and attention. We can clear and open your heart and schedule so that you can give more time and energy to the children who need you. That is an aside on this reading for someone here. I felt the need to say you are like a teacher or an educator. You are also nurturing your inner child at this time, and that is what has made expressing yourself so difficult, especially in the realm of sexual connections. I am no counselor, guys. I am no therapist. I read tarot, but I know what I'm looking at, okay? Please consult a regular doctor for anything else. Alrighty. We have Merope, Gateways of Light. Infinite. I have unlimited access to the divine mind. That is the truth, by the way. And there is love here for you, Gemini. Your intuition, this Queen of Cups. Intuition. I have unlimited access to the divine mind. And this is reminding you that love is possible. And you're meant to be an example of love here on Earth. You are the lovers, after all. So, don't doubt what you're capable of. Don't doubt the love that you are capable of showing, and that is that you are capable of, that's capable of being reciprocated back to you. And what you give back, Gemini. So, Remember. If you did this to someone, it's being done to you. That's how I feel. If that's for someone, yeah. Oh boy, hello. Yeah, we have flowers and scrying mirror. Not my two favorite cards, but here we go. Alright. Scrying mirror and flowers. How fickle is woman? Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay. Here we go. I would really love to break this reading down some more. So guys, do reach out if this is your story. I have never wanted to do this for anyone before, but I'm feeling it for you today, Gemini. Okay. You know, let's read flowers first. And the short and sweet of this card, guys, is fickle. If you have been playing games with someone's emotions, even your own, the flowers card could come to ask you to make up your mind before you lose what could be a great relationship. Possibly just exactly what you have been hoping for. Take stock of your behavior. Are you devoted one minute, then backing off the next? Leaving things totally up in the air? Your lack of decisiveness is affecting others' happiness, as well as your own. Now is the time to look at the root of the problem, fear. Ask yourself, what exactly are you afraid of? What exactly are you afraid of, Gemini? Because that speaks again to this inner child wounding from the past. It does. That is no accusation, guys, by the way. Sorry. I know my words, I'm a Libra, by the way. My words can be quite cutting. I don't intend to be. It's just, I think about things so quickly. Anyway. Uh-huh. That is no criticism, is what I meant to say. Alright, scrying mirror. Projection. You currently desire something so strongly your focus is completely blinkered, and you cannot see the pitfalls that might come from achieving your goal. The scrying mirror card reveals that your obsession for possession has blinded you to some negative aspects of your goal. It is vital to be completely clear about what you wish for, lest someone, including yourself, is harmed in the process of gaining it. Monitor your thoughts and words at every moment, as what you give out will come back. Sometimes threefold. Gaze long and deep within, intending to truly understand your ambition. When you recognize that everything that happens is merely your projection, your focus will change, and the reflection of the love in your heart will dazzle others, and ultimately yourself. Geminis, I hope something in this reading did resonate with you. Please let me know down in the comments. Leave a like on the video if something did. I look forward to hearing from you. Let's break it down, Geminis. I will see you next week for your general love readings. Until then, my friends, be well.